Hello P5, it's Miss Claire again, and welcome to our Math 5 class. In this video, we will continue the lessons for Chapter 3 about angles. And you will learn about estimating and measuring angles, and also angles on a straight line. You can find this lesson in your learner's book pages 39 until 45. Here are the learning objectives of this lesson. To estimate and measure the size of an angle in degrees, and to calculate angles on a straight line. Are you ready, P5? Okay, relax, enjoy, and have fun learning this lesson. Now let's discuss first about estimating and measuring angles. Let's review the different angles that we learned from lesson 1. We have the right angle. It measures 90 degrees. Next is an acute angle. It measures less than 90 degrees. Another is an obtuse angle. It measures more than 90 degrees but less than 180 degrees. And the other angle is that a straight angle. That measures exactly 180 degrees. So don't forget these four types of angles. Now, I have here the word math. Let's find the angles in each word or letter. Let's start with letter M. What are the angles that we can find in letter M? Yes, we have acute angles. How about letter A? Letter A consists of acute angles and obtuse angles. How about letter T? It has two right angles. And how about letter H? Yes, there are four right angles. Before we estimate and measure an angle, we need to study first a protractor. Okay, children, prepare your own protractor. A protractor is a measuring tool used to measure an angle. It is marked equally into 180 parts, and the scales are marked from 0 degrees to 180 degrees. This part here, we call it the center mark. The black line, we call it the baseline. And a protractor has two scales. We have the outer scale and the inner scale. So the outer and inner scale are marked from 0 degrees to 180 degrees. So this 0 here and this 180 here, these are the outer scale. And this 0 and this 100 up until 180, and this is what we call the inner scale. So which scale we will use when we measure an angle? It depends on our angle. So let's learn on how to use a protractor. Let's say we have an angle, this angle. How to use a protractor? Make sure that you place the center mark of the protractor over here, the corner of an angle, like this. So, this one, we have our center mark. Next, you need to make sure that the baseline of the protractor is located on this line. Okay? So, make sure that the baseline is adjusted on that part. Now, when we measure an angle, we will start from the baseline. So, our baseline starts from 0 degrees. And our angle is until here on line A, line EB. As we can see, this is until 90 degrees. So this angle measures 90 degrees because this is a right angle. Now, let's estimate the sizes of angles. We know that an acute angle, children, measures less than 90 degrees. So let's say that our angle A measures 55 degrees because this is smaller than 90 degrees. Our angle B is an obvious angle. So let's say that this is 100 degrees since 100 degrees is bigger than 90 degrees. Now for us to measure or find the correct sizes of angles, we can measure it using our projector, of course. So let's measure the sizes of these angles. We have angle A and we have angle B. Using the projector, okay, make sure the baseline is on the zero. So as you can see, this angle is here and this one. This is the measurement of this angle. So this is 50 degrees. So angle A is 50 degrees. How about angle B? So again, now in this case, we will use the outer scale. So starting from zero from the baseline and until here. So this angle is 110 degrees. Another example, let's measure other angles. Okay, we have angle P and angle Q. Look at angle P, let's measure. We will use the inner scale. So from zero in the inner scale, okay, as you can see, this is 40 degrees. So angle P is 40 degrees. How about angle Q? In angle Q, we will use the outer scale. This one is starting from zero and it ends until, yes, this is 80 degrees. Okay, so that's how to use a protractor using the outer and inner scale. For this part, you can try to measure these angle, children. Okay, you can try what are the sizes of these angles. Now, let's study about angles on a straight line. I have here two right angles. Yes. A right angle measures 90 degrees, so if we have two right angles, that is equal to 180 degrees. And remember, an angle that measures 180 degrees is what we call a straight angle. I have also here two angles. Let's measure the left angle. Let's check. It is equal to, yes, 100 degrees. How about the angle on the right side? Let's measure it. As you can see, we rotate a bit our projector because we make sure that the baseline is on the straight line. So as you can see, this angle measures 70 degrees. Okay, so it's as you can see, these two angles, children, are sharing a common side and also a common point. It means they are located side by side. This kind of angles that are sharing a side and a common point is what we call an adjacent angle. I have here another two angles. Let's measure the left angle. Let's see. Yes, it is also measures 100 degrees. How about the other side? Let's measure the other side. Yes, it's 80 degrees. Okay, these two angles also are adjacent because they are sharing one side and also one point, a common point. However, if we will add these two angles, it is equal to 180 degrees and that is a straight angle. Now, if two angles, children, that add up to 180 degrees is what we call a supplementary angles. Okay, so an adjacent angles can be a supplementary angles as long as it measures 180 degrees. But if you have two adjacent angles but does not add up to 180 degrees, that's not a supplementary angles. Okay, I have here two angles also. The first angle measures This is equal to 130 degrees. And the other angle, it measures, let's see. Yes, it's equal to 50 degrees. As you can see, these two angles are not adjacent angles because they are not sharing a side and a common point. However, if we will add 130 degrees and 50 degrees, it equals to 180 degrees. So these two angles here are supplementary angles. As long as these two angles add up to 180 degrees. Now, so remember this, children, an adjacent angles are two angles that share a side and a common point. It's okay if the total sum of the angles is not 180 degrees, as long as they are sharing a side and a common point. A supplementary angles on the right hand should be equal to 180 degrees. They can be adjacent angles or not, as long as it add up to 180 degrees. So children, that's all about estimating and measuring angles and angles on a straight line. I will discuss more about this lesson during our Zoom meeting. And remember to prepare your protractor. Thank you for watching P5. And always remember to stay safe and healthy. God bless everybody and have a great day.